No, they know a lot of the things, and that's been a lot of the issue with them.
Did you manage to learn about that?
With the budget and the financial report.
How cool that would be.
$25 miles an hour, you could afford to pay for it. And a lot of you have to.
Learn about that would be.
Have you around it? I like that idea. You know, I have you.
And then we put a statue of you.
Shirt off, like you both. It might look a little bit like you.
I asked Joseph.
Do you get a copy of this too, the response?
Oh, I did, yes, sure.
We could put Colonel Law. And so we'll take down the manor house, put Colonel Law with it.
It was a double plea failure here.
I did ask Joseph. She's downstairs.
I know. I know. I know where she, yeah, okay. She's done with all those nice people down there. People that could take care of everyone.
Well, you know.
Guys and girls.
Yes.
I met one of the girls the other day when I was in here. She had just finished her agility test, and I asked her what it meant. Oh, my gosh.
We've gone back and forth, and we've got a couple of good ideas, but nothing that, you know, adds about it, nothing to say, oh, that's it. We're coming, we got a few that we like.
Because it's based on the weight of your.
I like the committee, because it's like people, like money, like.
No, that's not.
And it's not your typical.
The agility, I don't think I can run through the cones and that, so.
Well, that's, yeah.
All right. Let's get started, be conscious of everybody's time. I did ask Josephine, but we don't have a liquor permit, so sorry, you did not get Guinness tonight in honor of St. Patrick's Day. Or I would have brought it all. My grandpa would have loved that. So we're going to get started. First of all, we're going to go through the operating real quick. We really had made all the decisions when we talked the first time, then we talked last time. So this is meeting number four. And then we'll talk very briefly on capital. And then anything new that the mayor or Rhonda has for us. And then I've been asked if we could review revenue projections and, you know, how could we potentially do revenue for this year? Because we need a revenue stream. I think a lot of it, if you looked at the information that the mayor passed out, which also was then in Cleveland, it was in the Plain Dealer. On the front page, I believe, Mayor, about the taxes and reductions.
The local government fund.
Half a million for us and $22 million for Cleveland. We moved it, so.
Jay and I do have.
There's a lot of, you know, Kasich in that. And the Senate really did an interesting dichotomy to want to help, but we need the money. So we're going to talk about that also. So we'll first start out with operating.
Jay, could I just make a point here, please? I asked for the breakout of the certificate of estimated resources.
Which was in that.
Under other transfers in. And she provided that to us. One of the, I found a couple of areas that are in question. If you want to handle that later, fine. Or if you want to handle it now, fine. But I did find a couple of things.
Are they in addition to what you put into writing to us already?
Yes, I just, she didn't send this to us until, I didn't have a chance to actually go through this till I saw her response to me.
Yes, it was in the email.
What are the details?
Yes, it did.
Today.
Yes. So I wasn't able to respond until I actually saw them. That was included in the email today. And it's a couple of areas only.
Okay, ask them real quick then, because we're.
Okay, so it appears that the Sagamore Hills dispatch contract was repeated as of last year, but this year it's supposed to go to 76,141.82.
Can you tell us what you're referring to?
This is the attachment that she provided in her email concerning the detailed.
And that's the transfers in, right here.
It's part of other. It's the other, the $2 million.
It's the details behind that number.
Okay.
Okay? And I did see that you, would you like me to stop while you're looking?
Kevin, see all this that you were just handed?
See this one?
It's the last page.
Okay.
Oh, I see. The last page. 57 on it.
It's a staple copy.
Yeah, it says 57.
Keep going.
It has teeny tiny print. I was able to see it.
Okay.
And the.
What is the question on the table about the Sagamore Hills?
Well, she just showed me that there's a contract, I guess, that where it increases from 57,000 to 76,000.
Yes.
For this year?
Yes.
Yes. That was signed last July.
So we can make that 76.
Right.
So that gives us a couple more bucks.
Okay.
Not enough.
Also, there, and I tried to find this, and I couldn't, in your list, the, not, you had the local government sales tax fund, which is $31,577, but I didn't see the local government reimbursement of $177,380.55. Is that someplace else, or where is that?
And what is that for, the 177?
That's just a, that's local government funds that you're given annually, and that would be on that. If you go down there, it's right below the sales tax. At the top, pretty far. I'll try to mark it if you can't find it real quick.
What was it last year?
Is it the 177 you're talking about?
What was the account number?
Yes, uh-huh.
What was the account number last year? So here.
Huh?
What was the account number last year?
Okay, the account number last year, I gave it to her.
Yeah, so it's
4210.
4211.
Excuse me.
That's okay. 4211. I'd have to look to in my detail to see if I included that.
It did not appear to be the case, just following down the track.
And that was from what?
That's, I just showed her what.
Last year.
From last year, that was.
Yeah, but what was it called?
Local government reg.
Yeah, which.
So I'm not sure if
it's right here, Janet.
Registration, or I'm not sure what that's for.
Yeah, it's basically. They used to give us 300 and some thousand, and now they give us 177 something. That's all.
Okay,
well, we got to double check to see if that number's still the same, because that may be one of those that is dwindling down, because it's local government, and perhaps does it come from the state?
Yes.
Yes, it has been this number, around this number. They did do a big whack when Kasich came in, but they haven't really done anything else since then. This has been pretty consistent over the last 3 years. So I think that maybe that just got missed.
Could be, yeah.
And I had one other question, and I don't know the answer to it, but I was looking at the number for the mayor's court, and I couldn't find it in the revenue stream quickly. I saw we did have some here, but it didn't add up to the number that you had. So I was wondering where all that came from.
I'm pretty sure, like, I looked at last year's and added up a bunch of line items.
Okay, well, you may have added up more line items than are here in this particular report. So I just thought I would ask that question, since I couldn't, when I added it up, it didn't add up to that number.
So just to recap on those first two numbers, that would go into the column where it's 2.128 right now. It could be an additional 253.
Yes, correct. You're right. Okay. So that was.
But we need to check on local government fund, because it's been from the years 2010 and 13. It went
you know what? I take it's not 253.
Yeah, it went down by 46%.
It's 76 minus 57, whatever that number is, because you
right,
already have
correct.
It for 57.
It's about 20,000 more.
So it's 20,000. Right. So
but we
19,000 to be exact.
Yeah, so yeah. Right.
We can't count on the local government fund until we validate what the real number is, because it has gone down.
So we know we're at least probably going to be up 19.
It's been consistent.
It's gone down by 46%. That's one of those that was impacted on the statement that the mayor gave to us.
Yes, I am aware of
it.
It
was in the paper.
I understand it was in the paper, but this has been consistent over the last 3 years.
Okay. I would check.
Yep.
So how much do we add?
We're adding, right now we're adding 19,000.
So it comes out to 2,147.
Yeah, and I believe that you will find that you should be adding the additional 100 in.
And which line is that? That's back on the.
That's on the certificate.
That's on the certificate.
On the last page.
Mm-hmm.
So it went from 2128 to 2147.
Right.
And it potentially should go to about 177,000 more, which I believe it will.
If we have the local, whatever the local is.
Right.
Right.
Okay.
So I'll check on that.
We're not talking. A pound of a million.
No,
it's not a million, but 200,000 sort of makes us
worry. And if we get rid of the 95 from 201 or 202, whatever that is.
Yes, we can get rid of the 95.
Not yet.
Why not? What is the issue?
We're waiting for ODOT's comment.
So you will check the local fund to see what they're going to give us this year.
Right.
All right, so we're going to check on 177.95.
Okay. Moving right along then, let's talk operating. There are two pieces of legislation on tonight's agenda for Robert Raddick. I said his name wrong, my apologies. Rachel Gambetes.
Right.
Those two, Mayor, are replacements.
Correct.
That were already placed in.
Rachel is replacing Andrea. And Bob Roddick is replacing Mike Lang.
Are they budget neutral then?
Correct.
So they are coming in at a lower rate, true?
Correct.
A little bit, yeah. Okay.
We just had adjustments.
And are they coming?
No, not yet.
Were they both full-time before?
Both full-time before, and I'm still working out. I mean, we're likely going to have, Bob's got, he's going to step in as a part-time immediately, and then we'll see how that's going to work into a full-time.
Okay, so are both of them full-time, or Bob is going to be part-time?
Bob's going to step in immediately to help us get through this interim period.
Okay.
And my hopes are is that I'll eventually get into the full-time slot.
That he's going to start part-time with a potential full-time, but the dollars we spent last year, were those two full-time?
Correct.
Okay, so we actually have a little bit of savings for now.
Apparently not.
When you put them in the budget, though, did you put them in as part-time or full-time?
No.
We put them in at full-time at this time, because we didn't know what the outcome's going to be, so we have it in as full-time.
Okay.
For sure, the replacement of Andrea is certainly going to be equal to that. And then the only issue we have, and we know it's not going to be as much, by the way, it's going to be for sure about $15,000 or so less if it were to be the full-time.
Okay.
Then I'm not understanding that, because we actually increased the salary wages line in, as I indicated in that email.
Right.
And so if this is budget neutral or going to be less, I'm not following how we end up with the numbers that we have in the building department, which the 2016 appropriation is 275, 391, whatever, 500. And then the actual for 2015 was 244, 740, 48. So it sounds like it's not budget neutral. So what is creating the $31,000 difference?
Well, you added Janelle as a zoning inspector.
Okay.
So we had the budget, the building commissioner, the assistant building commissioner, two administrative staff, and now we have a zoning inspector as well.
Okay. So what we're doing is we're increasing the cost of the building department by.
But that was increased before Mike left. You know, that was with Mike included in that. So, yeah.
I don't understand what that means. I mean, we had a building department, which cost us X amount last year through December, and it was 244, 740, and now it's 275, 500. So that's not budget neutral. So you're saying that we're hiring additional people, or that
they're
more
expensive?
No,
we're not hiring additional people. We're actually.
Because did Dennis do the zoning last year?
Dennis did the zoning. And Dennis,
so now you have a zoning inspector, and Dennis is coming on in part-time.
Yeah.
So.
I'm going to say this to you. That department's probably going to run much less than the way it is currently. And I don't have the exact number yet, because I don't know how I'm going to fit Roddick in. But I'll say this, it's probably going to run quite a bit less, because first of all, we're bringing in Janelle at a much less rate than what was being paid to Dennis.
Yes, I am aware.
Dennis is going to come back as a part-time person.
So
I think that.
And you have the $32,500 for the retainer for the engineer in that.
Yeah, the $32,000 is for the retainer of the engineer, which was not in there before.
Right. Well, it seems to be adding up to a higher bottom line. That's all I'm saying. And if you look at every one of the fee areas and what they're inspecting, everything is down from the previous years. The trend is going down, I expect, because we're almost built all up, as you have pointed out in that Charter Review Commission. So I'm kind of,
And that's one of the reasons that I'm contemplating this more on a part-time basis at this time. But I can't assure you of that until I know where I'm going with it. But for the sake of being budget neutral, it certainly is that, because we're not increasing anybody. The only part of that which is increasing is obviously the cost of the increase of wages, which is included in that number, and the $32,000 for the engineer retainer. So that kind of balances that number back to where it should be.
I'm trying to follow why that is. So I mean, why is it balancing anything? The bottom line number in this is higher than before.
It was 244 versus 275.
Yeah, I know. That's just salaries and wages.
If you take the 32,000 and add to the 244, what do you come up with? 276.
I get that. I understand that. I'm just saying it's not budget neutral if you add $31,000. That's all I'm saying.
Well, you have an engineer. You got to pay him.
Well, I know, but we paid the engineer last year too.
We're paying him on a retainer, so we're putting it in there. I mean, I don't understand.
Well, they paid him last year too. We did allocate funds for them.
We paid him under not part of payroll though. Yeah.
I understand we didn't. The bottom line.
So it's not budget neutral because it does not come out to zero, but if we look at our budget every year, these line items have gone up because of pay increases, salary, as well as pension, and we've made some changes under the new administration, but we're not bringing in exasperating a dollar amount.
I think it's because we added Janelle as an inspector, whereas Dennis would have left.
But Janelle was part-time before?
She was in finance.
No, she was a full-time employee.
Right. Okay, but
she was full-time and you were in finance.
I'm asking the mayor.
What's it? She was full-time in the finance department. We laterally moved, we didn't laterally move. She moved over now to become the zoning inspector.
And then Dennis's hours are decreased.
Dennis is retiring at the end of the month. He'll be gone for 3 months.
Yes.
There was a question, I think maybe you had asked it, about are we able to bring Dennis back?
Yes.
That was removed. That clause was removed in January.
That's a good thing.
When we did the pay, the one that we just amended again, that clause was removed.
Okay.
So it is okay to bring him back because we did have that clause. Yeah, that was a long time ago.
Right.
Where you could not rehire, but that's been removed. So legally, yes, you can bring them back. I checked that out with Josephine because I wasn't aware.
Well, here's the numbers that I'm referring to. In 2015, the actuals for personnel, that's including salaries, overtime, et cetera, were $337,716. And this year, it's $429,500. And below, we have an increase also in the operating dollars, a little less than that, about $16,000. So the total difference in terms of the billing department from 2015 is $545,575 in 2015 and $651,750 in 2016. I'm just looking at the detailed appropriation.
The budget in 2016 said $651,750. The budget now says $689.
Yes.
An increase of $38,000.
Well, that's the carryover number.
No, that's you're including the carryover.
Yeah, right. That's the carryover number. So
it's a difference of $106,000.
But our budget is $651,000.
Yes,
our budget last year was $545,000.
Yeah, it's $106,000 difference, and it's not budget neutral. I mean, every department that gets increased means that we are putting pressure on general fund, obviously. And a lot of these departments do have increases. Now, there were some increases, as you pointed out, the $154,000 for the 2.75% salary increase across the board. So that was going to be added to the general fund. But that is distributed across the entire structure. So that each individual department wasn't suffering. Obviously, the two biggest departments, fire and police, I mean, in terms of cost, are the ones that have the most of that money. But so I'm just saying these numbers are not budget neutral, and I think that, you know, given the situation that we're in, adding $100,000 here, $100,000 there to financial issues.
Why is that $100,000 different coming?
But it's not $100,000.
The operating is only.
Are we talking because of the benefit part of this?
That's what increased the most.
Pension increase, compensation increase, unemployment increase, so.
You mean that the.
And a retainer.
The retainer's up above, which I think last year it might have been down below.
We have a retainer in the building department, is that Dennis?
It was, Rhonda.
But I don't see it in last year's expenditures as a line item.
Is Dennis the retainer?
No, the engineer, Don G.
Okay, so who's the 32.5?
That's Don.
That's him.
That's, okay.
So, but the.
So I'm not sure where the retainer was last year, because I don't see a line item.
They didn't have that way, they were paying under a different structure. But they were paying him, obviously.
Right, but was it out of building?
Yes.
Okay, any other questions, because we went through and agreed of the replacements.
Well, I don't know that we did.
So are you now saying you don't want to replace? Because we already agreed to that, that's why she made the numbers.
Because Janelle was approved for.
I understand Janelle was approved, but we didn't know about Mr. Rodick, and we didn't know about anything else.
Mr. Rodick's being approved tonight, but he was just a replacement for Mike.
Well, I understand, but whatever the replacement structure is, it's costing us $100,000+ more, that's all. So I don't know that we approved that idea of it yet, because we haven't approved the budget. So my point in looking at this was to say, how come we're, in various areas, we're adding cost when we have a structure at this point that we say we need to be looking at?
Wasn't the part $20,000 for the, $22,000 for the scanning of all the documents?
The $22,000, that's what that's for.
So that's included in that number two?
Yes.
Let me ask that question, because I thought that they were saying they had bought a scanner. Are they saying they didn't and they have to now get one, or are they getting?
We have a scanner there, but they're scanning everything new in?
Yes.
And all the.
Old stuff.
Old stuff, there was an entire room, probably half the size, that was loaded from floor to ceiling.
I get that. I get that might be something to consider. All I'm saying is, if we're in a strictured period, which you say we are, maybe that scanning everything back to when Hector was a pup is not necessarily the thing to do this year. Maybe we can do that next year.
If we didn't buy that house over there, we would have had enough money to have that.
But this, we had to do it to get, make the office for the interior.
Well, obviously, we made a choice to do it, is what you're saying.
Okay, does anyone else have any questions? Because the one question you asked about the finance was answered on February 29th. So, you know, is there any other questions about the operating?
Well.
Dave? I'll ask each one of you, so you get your moment here.
What's the percentage that we've been increasing operating from last year?
That's a good question.
With or without transfers?
Well, first off, without transfers.
Right.
Yeah, just what is the increase? What's the percent, please? Because I hate to say it, every year we've gone up.
I guess it was part of that. What's the total increase, I'm sorry?
Yes, well, the bottom line total without transfers is the question.
That's what she's doing.
Right.
Nick, while she's doing that, do you have anything?
No, not on that, no.
Mr. Bilke?
Not on that subject, no.
Mayor, do you have anything else to say while she does her math calculations? All right, then we'll come back to you, Dave, but that way, do you have any others?
It's an 8.5% increase.
What's the total amount?
For 2016, the total increase is $800,815.
Right, $800,000?
$915.
Right.
Now, let's, and I don't take that as, you got to remember, there's some encumbered numbers in there from last year that are being carried. None of the encumbers?
No, I didn't include those.
You didn't include those?
No.
Okay. So the 815 is the new hires for the police?
Yep. All the replacements, new hires, everything that's been
discussed,
approved as of last week.
Everything that we agreed upon.
Right. Just for the general fund, yes.
Right. Bridge was the upper.
So we have an $850,000.
$800,915.
$800,950, which is an 8%.
Yeah.
Mr. Engel, do you have any other questions?
Well, I guess the question then is, and I'm not sure what you were referring to, but transfers, but I guess the general question is then, is with an $800,000 increase in the operating fund, are we, is this going to be a budget, a balanced budget?
Yes.
And when you're balancing the budget, we've been talking about need to bring in additional revenue. You're telling me that it's a balanced budget without need?
Without that needing.
Okay, or without?
We took out an additional debt that we don't have yet, and then I took out capital improvements that we were discussing last week to take out.
What do you say? You took out additional debt?
So I had in the revenue side, I had $2.2 million of debt that we would have to get, or additional revenues to help cover capital improvements.
Okay.
So I removed that revenue.
Okay.
And then we removed capital items that haven't been approved yet.
Okay, and so you're telling me that with the operating budget as it is, based on the income that we're having, we're not going to need to borrow any money to
not meet. If we spend what's in here. No?
Right, that's what I'm trying to
get. Well, here's the point. If we add $800,000, we can't spend it on capital items.
Right, I know. We haven't got that far.
Right, I know we haven't got there yet, but I'm saying if you increase this by
general fund,
the capital items get blown out.
Excuse me, Kevin has a question on the table.
I got it.
Kevin, what was your question?
She answered it.
Well, what was your question? What was her answer?
It was, even with that increase, where would we end the year at? It would be 500 and.
$86,775.
Say that again?
It's the previous sheet.
$586.
$586,744.
With maybe 272 more rolling in.
You're going to have to tell me what that sheet is called or help me find it.
Actually, 300, because it'd be 19 more than that.
Right. Kevin.
All right, so you're saying there's a carryover of 585?
$586,775.
That we're carrying over at the end of the year?
That if we spend the money on the operating side, we don't have the money to pay for capital improvements.
Sylvia, be respectful. Dave has a question on the table. He's trying to get an answer. Other people may benefit from that. Please.
I'm not being disrespectful. I was trying to explain to him the point.
That's disrespectful to Dave.
Okay.
I'm not complaining.
He's not complaining.
So say what you told Dave so everybody can hear.
We will have a carryover at $586,775 with the assumption that we spend everything that we've appropriated,
right,
which, you know, could not be, might not be the case.
And then
estimating that we're not going to get any additional increase in revenue that we have here.
And we're not touching the emergency reserve.
Right.
So, and obviously we're not touching the pension reserve, which is another emergency reserve.
We're not touching that. So the revenue, we know that the other's going to go up. So then the carryover will then go up.
What is
the other for? The other revenue here, we already know that it's going to go up probably by 20,000 because of Sagamore.
Oh, okay.
And then I have to check the local government. So this will go up, which will make the total go up. So the carryover will be.
Okay.
So when we say an 8.5% difference in the general fund, we can certainly take out the increase in wages by the 2.75 off of that, and then you can obviously then apply those new employees into that.
Right.
Why would you do that?
Well, because I'm trying to compare apples to apples, oranges to oranges, and if you are talking about the increase from last year to this year, you're looking at the increase of wage increases of 2.75 across the board.
Yes, that's 154,000.
And then you're also looking at the operating cost of just generally of about probably 3% of what it costs you to do business, generally speaking.
Joe, she had already provided an estimate of that.
Well, I'm just trying to clarify it so for everyone else's ears, they can hear what I'm saying.
It's
so
probably
that you're not saying that it's a pure, I just jumped 8.5%. I have some things in there that are contributing to that.
Yeah, I don't want somebody to walk away from here and say, oh, the general budget has gone from here to there, and it's 8.5%. There's got to be an explanation. Well, what's involved in that? So I'm throwing out those explanations.
Okay, so it includes 2.75 wage increase, about a 3% cost of doing business. I think that's a low estimate.
No one seems to be talking about is those are replacements too. This isn't anything new. So the replacements are in that 8.5%.
Well, of course.
So replacements are something we've already had. We just failed to backfill them up to this point, which would probably add up to a majority of that.
No, it isn't.
I'm sure it's a high number. It's not small.
Well, the replacements.
I can just think off my head over $150,000 that would cover a lot of it.
The replacements are generally.
But it's in the 8.5%.
Except for, like, the finance director and apparently somehow how we're doing the building department. Generally, the replacements of the police would make it lower. You know what I mean? And it is 2.75% more. That's true. Because
that's
of our
number, the IT guy who's now taking away from the contracted services, so, you know, that's dropping that number.
That was part of the question.
Okay. Any other questions?
No.
Any other comments, Rhonda or the mayor?
No.
Before we move into capital.
I do have some more questions here, if I may, concerning the operating budget.
Are they on your list? Because a lot of those questions we already talked
about.
Except can you pick out one that maybe we didn't talk about? Because we did, as I read these, like we talked about this, I found notes where we've talked about it. What else do you have?
I'm sorry, but some of these things we haven't talked about. And
such as?
It's a good, for example, the details of some of these we didn't know, and I certainly didn't know about Mr. Rodick or any of that other stuff as we discussed.
We were going to replace.
No, I did not. I had no idea what we were going to do because.
What did you think we were going to do with the building?
Well, let's not get into what somebody did or didn't do.
Wait a minute. We talked about every department's needs, every department if they wanted a replacement or new.
Right.
We talked about would we do replacements. Then we talked about if we do new. Then we said, no, we can't do this. So. Okay. I'm confused at what part of replacements and then I sent out the note that said this would be replacements. Rhonda sent out this would be the cost of new hires versus replacements. So I guess we're all kind of sitting here going, did you miss?
Part of the issue is, of course, that we've changed the budget dramatically several times, okay? Because when we discussed the adding all these hires, we discussed the fact that that was going to be too overwhelming in terms of cost. If we had started with the baseline that had last year and then we said we want to add these things, it would have been easier to compare.
We did have a baseline. She gave us 14, 15, 16. Here's the minutes from the March 9th meeting that shows who we were going to do. So what's your question? Because I don't want to repeat things that we've done.
Well, we're in a point of discussion, are we not? We just talked about something about how much more this is this year.
So what's your question?
Jan, why did you not interrupt her? Let her get
because, Dave, we talked about it. We have minutes. We have examples. I'm not going to rehash for everyone sitting at this table. They didn't have any questions.
Well, we made several major points.
Let me ask you this, Sylvia, before we go. Did you get the response from our administration to you as it related to your questions?
I did.
Okay.
I did.
What out of all those questions, without having to go through every one of them, because we answered every one of them, which ones are the most particular to you, please?
Could I just say this to you, Joe, so that I could be understood here? I didn't ask the questions so that we could say we've answered them. I thought it should be a point of discussion, which is things like, for example, the $800,000 more in this budget was important to know. The fact that there may have been some revenue sources missed, that was important to know. So my thought was we ought to look at some of the other areas here and determine whether there's additional things that we could perhaps reduce at this time. And my objective at this point would be to try to increase the amount of money we can afford for capital as opposed to operating.
Well, let me say this to you, Pat.
Okay.
You could certainly try to squeeze.
Yes.
But you're not going to be able to squeeze enough to even put a dent in our capital needs.
Well,
there's no question about it. this is a template that I'm offering as our basic budget. There may be a little bit, some of these items may be a little bit over, and it's being, and some may be below and too conservative. This was just an outline of what we need. As you know, this is always a working document, and as time goes on, there's probably going to be a couple of approaches back to reappropriating the dollars within here. We're discovering, every time I turn around, we're discovering things that we have to pay for that didn't necessarily show up, like this ODOT thing for that $115,000.
For specialized construction.
Or for specialized construction for the $3.5 million that we spent on roads last year.
Well, here's the thing.
So, you know.
There's an example right there, Joe. There's money in a fund called the Permissive License Act that was supposed
yes.
to, that's supposed to pay for Highland Road.
Yes. And that's in here.
Can we hold it? Let's get operating done. Then move over to capital.
I do have one question, and I can't find it real quick. I thought we said four seasonals, and I think you budgeted for five.
I'm sorry?
I thought you said four seasonals for the service.
Four seasonals. We budgeted
for five.
For five.
Right. Okay.
Well, there you go.
So those were already from prior years, so those weren't the additional ones.
Oh,
you're talking about.
Okay, gotcha.
You're talking about.
Okay.
Those are the ones that were already there, and then
you were
talking about
that was the one that she questioned is in the park, the one that.
Right, and then the two part time, you put those in the park?
The park had two part time plus five seasonal.
Gotcha, so they were in addition, they were already in there.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. The permissive tax.
Yes.
Gotcha, that was my question.
What about the permissive tax? We got about $166,000, I think,
well,
coming.
Well, it's about $112,000.
Last year, there was $111,500 that should have been paid to fund 401 to help cover those expenses.
Right.
So I have budgeted to transfer or to reimburse fund 401 for that $111,000.
Right.
I found out that we are eligible for another $150,000 this year, but it has to be used on state or
state and county
road. Right, like Highland Road or something.
Right.
Yes,
so
you're
when
aware
we get that project, if we get that project started, then we have to apply for the money. So it's
right.
I have it as an estimate coming in, but you can't get it until we have a project going on.
You can't count it as sub.
The new stuff, yes, but the old stuff has already been given to
us.
And we didn't expend it.
That's in Fund 203.
Right.
And I'm expending it out of 203 this year and giving it to 401 to help cover the reimbursement.
Well, okay, so is that the reason that specialized construction was billing us? Is that what happened or not?
No.
You can't use that permissive in interior roads.
Well, they were also doing, I believe specialized construction also worked on Highland Road. So that's my question.
No, this is
what was the bill for?
Was for Air Lane, Barkdale, Blueberry.
In other words, they didn't bill for that? That's
this is
shocking.
Right. This was construction that was budgeted in three line items in Fund 401.
Uh-huh.
And we found the total. We have paid them $958,000.
Right.
We have a bill dated 12/15 that I never saw before until yesterday.
Well, nobody ever saw that.
For $113,000. Well, we should have known that they were going to bill us because we knew the project was estimated at $1,120,000.
Yeah, but they said they came in below it.
Right, they came below, but then there was modifications to get $1,117,000.
Okay.
So we still owe them $114,000 for bills. Plus $44,800 for retainer.
Okay, so they're claiming that we didn't complete. They didn't completely bill us.
Right.
Even though they completed all this work,
yes.
Let's say by September.
Well, I this is dated December, so I have no idea.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I wonder about
but
that.
But that's not abnormal.
But that is why I had to send out a revised.
I understand. That's why I was asking what
well,
it was for.
Let me get the discussion back here. Then
I just want to review.
Well, that's what I was going to
okay,
do. There
so
questions?
This is what I have. This is the new ads. One IT director, one police, part-time jailing hours, one zoning inspector, four part-time seasonals, and two part-time service. So that's 10 new employees that we're adding.
We had one replacement with benefits for the police department.
I'm just saying that
we added $21,840 in part-time salaries for jailers, and then we were going to add one new hire police. We did nothing in the fire department.
Right.
We added two replacements in dispatch. We removed the new hire. And the only thing I remember doing for you.
For service.
Was your seasonal.
We have a replacement, and then we have a new hire, which, and then seasonal.
We didn't say two part-time?
Yeah, you're right. It was two part-time and some seasonal.
Two seasonal, one replacement.
Four seasonal, two.
So those are new.
Yeah, but there was.
Because those were the guys that.
That's what I'm saying. They were part-time. So that's, I just wanted to.
Yes.
Yeah, part-time.
These are, this is an addition to the replacements.
And let's clarify why we're asking for the additional part-time, so that we can do more road work and do more asphalt work and try, and that, so if we get that equipment, especially in the service department, we can go out and do major patch jobs. Like a guy called me a day or two ago, he says, can you send somebody out? He says, my, in front of my mailbox, it looks like a tornado hit. He says, all the gravel is just, the entire road is deteriorating. What should I do with this stuff? I mean, that's how all of our streets are in this town. It's just terrible.
So I'm not sure if all this adds up to 800,000, so I'm sure there's other things, but I guess my question to you was, are these essential for our city to move forward?
Absolutely essential.
But I think the some of the road service people, that's, if we don't have the money to buy the equipment, then we don't need these people.
Well, yeah, if we can't buy the equipment, but so, if we, I mean, then essentially what you'll do this year is nothing. You'll have nothing.
I understand, but I'm just,
yeah, I
mean, they're connected, that's my point.
They're connected, yes.
So the discussion for the capital, is that really was the only thing we're going to talk about? I have a quick one then.
Thank you, Jim.
Mayor, based on the email that you received and the recommendations or potential recommendations from Ms. Hannigan of reductions in different line items, was there any of them that you could entertain that would be acceptable within the budget without inhibiting your operating?
Yeah, based on all the answers that we, and Rhonda and I have gone over these, we've been very conservative on them. I think that this is what we need. This is what we have to do to make things work in the city right now, and this is our recommended budget. You know, that's what we're asking for.
Okay, so anything in here, you're not saying anything in here that you could.
I mean, we've cut a whole lot of stuff out. I mean, I got to tell you, there was a whole lot of a list probably that long, and narrowed it down to just about that much, unfortunately.
And I know I looked at line items, and based on what's been spent in 14 and 15 and what was budgeted last year, I reduced a lot of the budgeted line items from what was budgeted from last year to this year based on what was spent. And some line items I felt, you know, okay, we spent $48,000 and I budgeted for $60,000. There's a little bit of leeway, but there's not a lot.
Well, and I think that goes back to the department heads.
When with that line item, that specific line item might have been budgeted for $72,000 last year. So I cut it down to $60,000, so left a little leeway.
Yeah. I mean, we're working on things of how to cut other areas, but it's taken a while because we got to deal with, like, insurance contracts for the city liability and other, we got to deal with health insurance. That's obviously union tied, but we're going to be bidding that out or asking for RFQ by the, not RFQ, but RFP probably by midsummer. We'll start to hunt that out. I think we can save a whole lot of money in that area, but that is going to be something that I'll have to tie to the negotiations as we get into the union contracts as well.
Well,
okay, there's two things that stick out on here that. Sylvia, I'm reading from yours, and I'm trying to capsulize it so we don't get marred down. The one would be the trees, $30,000 more. That money is in the right line item, I hope, because it wasn't for 2 years.
Yeah, I'm pretty annoyed with that one there, and I don't know what the heck happened there, but that is a situation where there was plannings done in that subdivision, and I guess all the trees died.
Yes, that's.
And that's now true. To have to restore them, it's like.
Well, that's one where the ash or killed them all.
No, that wasn't
the other one. These were in Gardens of Highland, which should have happened within 2 years of them planting. They should have gone after the contractor for it.
Yeah.
It was left alone, and after that point, it became our responsibility. So when I first came in as interim, I had the trees removed because they were all dead. It's on us to replant them.
So that's not money that we would have gotten in through the tree fund. That's money that we have to expend because of the original error.
Yes.
Okay. The other one.
Could I just make a comment there? Could I make a
well,
comment?
Well, I haven't had it. Go ahead.
I just wanted to say this. That's a choice whether to do that this year or not. And when we're looking for things to reduce so that we have more money for expenditure on roads, then some of those things, we don't have to do everything this year in some of those areas which I believe are, you know, we're going to have to do them, but it could be.
I don't want to interrupt, but I will.
Okay, go ahead.
So the tree fund, these people build their house.
Yes.
And they pay for the tree up front, correct?
I believe that's true.
And so the city is supposed to come in within a certain time. So you guys know that in Lake Forest Estates, there's people that are going on 3 years that haven't bought their trees yet. And
I think these people got their trees, they died.
Yeah, not in Lake Forest Estates, they've never gotten it.
So you're bringing up a situation.
They've never gotten their trees, and I know that you've probably gotten calls from Rob Scott, who's heading up this people who have built their house and haven't got it, so.
How much are the trees on Highland, in the Highland that died? How much are we talking about?
But I think this is.
$30,000.
$30,000, yeah.
Being the mayor's budget, if you put the money in there, that doesn't say you're going to spend it, you may decide, you know what, I'm going to wait a year because of X, Y, Z, weather, the cost of the trees. The same as when, I see you've reinstated the rental program.
Well, there should be an escrow account, but that's what happened, that was the swap issue, by the way. Was what happened to all of them.
I don't want to rehash it, we'll talk about it, but I'm just saying that.
Remember the rental program?
What we think is to be put off, other people think that should have been done yesterday.
Well, I get what people think, I'm just saying, we're.
It's line item one.
And people will want what they want immediately, and in the case of some cases, as you're describing, in Lake Forest, they haven't received something they should have received.
That they've already paid for, right?
Right, correct. And I'm not saying that that's a particularly.
I'm not sure if it would come from that $30,000 or not.
Well, here's the thing.
Right, they're not replacements, they're new ones.
That's probably your more money.
There's also the replacements.
Right, I know, so as I was saying it, I thought in my head, well, that $30,000 is for replacing ones already, so.
So I think we understand that if you include it in the budget, that doesn't mean it may be spent, because the mayor has a proven record that, and these department has, John, you're new to the department, but you were part of the department that never went over your budget, and actually, we would be joyously when you used to come in under budget. The only other one I would bring up is the tool program, that's coming back.
I would like to have it back, and I would like to be able to have at least some tables and chairs and some odds and ends to.
Can we wait a year?
And we're not going to do it to the extent.
It's only $20,000, but can we wait a year?
I mean, we could wait a year, if we had to wait a year, sure. I mean,
it's only $20,000.
But I've had a lot of people request, you know, to come up and pick tables and chairs.
But the tables and chairs, that's probably $2,000-$3,000.
Next year, you could ask the same question.
Yeah, what we're saying here is this, and the general point is this, that we can, I realize that you're making a proposed budget. The council, in my view, is approving whether we allocate the way that you have laid out, or whether we make some adjustments. And that is our role, too. It's not simply the role of to accept and then let you decide whether you want to cut something someplace. Our role is to try to look at the problem. We're talking about 800,000 difference, an increase of the operating dollars over last year. So when we look at these items, that's why I went into some detail.
Every individual of us on the council have their own opinion, too.
Right, well, of course. I agree with
that.
Well,
one of the things we could do, which would right away save all the money, is we take away all the replacements that we agreed to. Three meetings ago. I mean, that's the. If you're looking for a big chunk of change, that's the only place you're going to find a big chunk of change. You're not going to find a big chunk of change going
right.
20
I've
here, 30 it. There. It's the big chunk of change you've got to look at. So anything else on operating, because that's pure operating. There are some things on her list that are capital, so.
Am I doing anything with that rental program?
Well,
reducing
with the tool program?
Yeah, the rental.
Anybody else's feeling? It's $20,000.
Well, this is my feeling, is that next year you could ask the same question,
right.
And the same answer would be, yeah, we could wait till next year.
Well,
so when does next year start?
Kevin, let me just show you something.
Oh, it can start in, you know. Your question, Kevin, it may never.
Well, that's I know. That's my point.
In any budget process, you can ask every year and be denied every year, which has happened.
What type of city do we want to be?
Okay, well, Kevin.
That's my point.
Right, so Mayor, that would be your question.
My question would be this. We have, if you look at this, we have had, if this is the city debt picture, and I will give you one.
We already got this one, right?
Right. And what I'm just trying to say to you is this. The choices this year are different from the choices next year. Okay? And the choices, we have a little over $1 million that we've been, that's why we can't repair roads, why we can't do a lot of things for the last 20 years. That's going away. So we can make choices then that are much easier to make next year than they could make them this year. That's all I'm saying.
What do we have things in the budget next year that we want to make it look like this, though?
Well, maybe so or maybe not. I don't know what you want to do there.
Part of the debt that goes off is the rec center. What pays the rec center is the rec center revenue that comes from the... You can't count that one in the operating fund. It can only be used the way it was written for the recreation center. So you can't just automatically say, voila, I have all this money from the rec center.
No,
I can spend it on the rec center. Sorry, Brenda.
That's okay. 2016, $470,000 is going to go away for next year in the general fund.
Correct.
Next year,
go away. This is the last payment we're paying out of the general fund.
Right.
Interest and principal.
That's true.
Next year's debt goes up by $200,000. So this number is incorrect.
Well, it goes up by $200,000 because that was created at the beginning of a different fiscal year. I'm just showing you as an example.
Right, but it's going to be $200,000.
It's going to be more. I understand that.
So what's the actual?
So it's like 200. It's going to be 700 and some thousand.
So we go down by 470 this year. We go back up by 200.
This was passed out to council with my adjusted numbers.
Okay.
At one of the council meetings. So you're going to increase your general fund by $470,000, but you're decreasing it by $200,000. So you're only going to get maybe not even $300,000.
Okay. All right, so great.
But that's not totally the picture, is what I'm saying. The picture is that 0.25% is going away.
That's in the rec center.
Right, but it's going away. It will not be there anymore. And the debt that we were paying for the rec center building is going away this year, right? Am I correct? So that 0.25%, which is around $1 million, could be then replaced by 0.25% that could address capital.
Well,
am I correct about that?
Yet.
Well, I know we're not there,
but
it's a point
in next year, and the 0.25% is only through June, so it's about $500,000.
Right. Well, I understand that. If we replace it,
renew it.
If we replace it, then we will have $1 million that we don't need to pay off this huge debt anymore, but we will have it for the purposes that we choose.
Ms. Huntington, let me guess. Your idea is to replace that. There's other ideas that
we
could do.
Well, I understand, but I'm just saying.
Can we just go forward?
Sylvia, could we hold that discussion? Our first discussion right now is we have a budget on the table.
Right. Okay.
Do we have any other changes that can be made that would find us $800,000? The first one off the bat is don't replace. Period. That's basically the only thing that you can give up. And we didn't go hog wild, as John will tell you, on replacements, because we're still not back to the projection you needed 5-7 years ago.
I think with $20 million plus road repair, curbs, stormwater related issues, that what we're asking to do in the service department especially is to try to put a Band-Aid over many of the problems that we have throughout the city. So what the service department's going to do is that with the proper equipment, they're going to go out and they're going to put Band-Aids on many of these roads so that we can get by. Because there is no way in the world that we can do $20 million in roads this year.
Unless
we decide how we're going to get a source of revenue into this city that is going to retire debt against $20 million presently, and perhaps $10 million that's backing that up, and within the next couple of years that $10 million that's backing that $20 million up is going to need to be done. So we're going to be talking about $30 million. So we need to take an aggressive position to get funding, if you will, to retire debt that is going to take us probably 10 years to get these $30 million in roads done.
I don't know what the number is, and nobody does at this point, but we haven't fixed these roads for the last 30 years. I mean, some of them over 40 years. We've just started to do that. That's true. And we had a lot of money tied up in two buildings. We know that. That money is not any longer needed.
Sylvia, last year, if we didn't spend all of the money and pay cash for all of these roads that you guys wanted to get done, we would have had a pretty healthy general fund. And I would have recommended that we go out and put a note against some of this road and get us a bigger bang for our buck instead of doing what we did. And I probably would have made a recommendation that we did more or a better type of install in moving culverts back and getting the job done right so that these roads don't deteriorate as quickly. That's part of the problems that we have.
Well, okay. I'm not disputing what you're saying, Joe. It's that we didn't make those choices. The choices were made by the mayor.
We funded
what he wanted. That's
beg,
all.
Beg to differ. I beg to
you
differ
on that.
I am
going
to differ with you on that because we decided 2 years ago, we said, let's do some roads. We had the money. And the majority of council said, no, we don't have the money. Last year, all of a sudden, we had the money and everyone agreed to. That was, we could have said, no, we did. But the question on the table is, on the operating, do you want to get rid of all the ads?
Go or
move ahead? We need to talk capital for poor old John Sitka because he's really the only discussion point we're going to get.
I'm satisfied with the answer.
Okay.
I think we need to do, we need to work through this and gain, we out of that 800,000, we need to gain about 200,000 back.
Well,
I think we
can. Mayor,
that's my opinion.
The
that's
mayor
him.
Has decided he doesn't have
well,
a spot
but
where
we're
he
deciding made. That, Jan, not the mayor. The mayor is proposing.
This is the mayor's budget.
Jan, it is the council budget when we
No. Council budget is only line number City Council. That's our budget. All we do is write
that
the
is
check.
Not correct. We approve the budget.
This
therefore,
is the administration
the
and mayor's budget. This is not Jan Pelley's budget, Sylvia.
We have to approve it.
It's not Dave Ingles. We may approve it, but
okay.
The
well,
mayor
you
has
and
to
I,
it.
Let's
it's
agree
it's
to
not,
disagree.
It's not, you know what?
You didn't write this budget. Sorry. This,
no, I'm not suggesting that I did.
I think I'm a very conservative individual, and I think that if wherever I'm going to save money, and I am going to save money, I'm going to certainly do that. And I'm going to back out whatever I can, and that'll obviously be proof in the pudding by the end of the year. In order for us to meet essential needs, I think we need to keep this in place and kind of move forward. I'm sure that we're not going to spend every line item in here, and I'm sure that there's going to be areas that we're not going to have more employees in or whatever. But if we want to meet some of these needs, which is, and I'll reiterate again, that if we have $20 million in roads, and let's assume that we have probably every street I can think of up in the air lane and all of those up there what we call the airport streets.
Yes.
Each one of those streets are falling apart to such a degree that we're going to have to get up there and do sections. We're going to have the equipment, we're going to have to go up there, and we need the manpower to do that. So in order for us to just do like areas like that, go to the commons and rip up areas or grind out areas and repatch areas and rebuild catch basins, we're going to need manpower and money.
And I am not disagreeing with you on that point. I think we should do that. I don't have a problem with that. I'm suggesting that we could wait a year on the SRO. For example, the policemen we're adding, that's a very expensive, that's almost, you know, $90,000 here. That's the kind of thing I think we should discuss because we need
we discussed it
well,
for 3 hours.
We did, but we're doing it in the context of what are the big choices here. That's what we're doing.
I think the primary question, and I respect and I understand where you're coming from, but right now, if we're to approve today what we have, obviously we're going to talk about the skid steer and all that stuff,
right.
But our unencumbered carryover would be 586. So let's just assume we cut out the extra officer that we were putting into the schools.
Right.
So that means it goes up to 686. Is that really going to set us free? Is that going to change the game for us so much that, you know, we're going to be just right where we want? I mean, I get what you're saying, and I think I'm understanding where the mayor's coming from at this point. But that one officer is not going to make this budget so perfect that we're all going to go, and we feel great about that. But I understand where you're coming from, but it just doesn't set us straight. It's not enough to say, yeah, we're good.
If we did no replacements, which are the dollars we had, we do no hiring, period, you'd give us a number of what the hiring was.
Well, the hiring was huge.
I think it was $679,000. If we did everything, we didn't. Well, we didn't do the fire, so I could take $250,000 out of there right off the bat.
Well, we did.
We did do any fire.
I know. We didn't. We took it out.
Right.
What I'm saying to you, Nick, well, you're leaving. Okay. What I'm saying to you, Nick, is that not just that policeman, but I believe there's enough money, like the rental program and the trees and that, we could come up with $200,000. If we wanted to do a note, which is what the mayor has said several times, and I do not object to, if we wanted to do a note till we can carry forward to a different amount of money being dedicated to capital, which would be next year, that we can possibly do that, then we could get a note for $1 million and basically have roll that into a larger contract next year.
I mean, that sounds like more of an administrative decision than it
well,
is a legislative
it's,
decision.
Well, I'm suggesting something else. It's not a decision. It's a possible way to look at it.
That's not what's been suggested to us.
Well, that's all right. We can have our own thoughts on it, right? Okay.
So what is the dollar amount if we do zero hire?
$510,500.
So we do no replacements, no new hires. It's a $500,000. It's the only way you're going to, I'm going to go back to the statement. The only way you're going to make, when you're talking, $200,000 isn't a lot of money. What you're saying, if you want to set aside, you've got to get into the $500,000 range. Because you don't count in your emergency fund. You can't count in your pension emergency fund. So if you want to hit add $500,000 more, get back to $1 million, you do zero hires, including replacements and new.
I think we've already established where we're going with that. Have we not? I think it's time we move on to capital portion.
Okay. I have one last question because this came up and it's come up several times and we've answered it several times. So we're going to get the final answer round up. You can do it in a question if you want. The computer maintenance, it was requested, can you make it all to zero?
No.
And I know you've already said you cannot, so you can explain it one more time.
We already have been using income for January, February, and March. So we still have to pay those bills. And then in the police...
And what are those bills?
For computer maintenance. I mean...
Yeah, I mean, what's the total?
Oh, I don't know the exact total because we're not closed.
We don't have them all.
I don't have them all either because, like, recreation had a virus at the beginning of the month, so I have no idea how much they're going to charge
okay,
us for March.
Okay, but is it, you know, $10,000?
I was looking at $10,000 a month at least.
Okay, so you're saying $30,000.
Right. Then the police and fire have line items for computer maintenance because they have different software and maintenance issues and
the GPS system, which
yes.
is tracking through their.
That can't
and
be
our
permitted.
IT person is not familiar with that.
It doesn't
or
matter
can't.
If he's familiar with it.
It's not a matter of what he's familiar with. It's a matter
it's
of
paying
what,
for the GPS system.
What the TAC, we're engaged with a company by the name of TAC that services and can only service the piece of or all that equipment, which is the GPS, the dispatch, aided dispatch with where the cars are and all that. So we can't change that. It's about $23,000, I think.
$23,566.
So it includes a little bit of income plus the $20,000, I think, for $20-some thousand for tax.
Uh-huh.
So you do not have exorbitant computer maintenance fees in here, but what you have in here would be to cover anything that we've already encumbered.
Right. And once March is over and we're done with income, then I would have a better idea of what those numbers can
so
go down
So it may go
to.
Down a little bit.
It could.
We can't say.
Right.
Okay. Moving along to capital. At our last meeting, we walked out with zero capital approved. In effect, John was able to present his case at the capital meeting, but we never really discussed, and we basically had said the fire department, we have...
Right.
We already encumbered that money. We have no choice.
The car, too, correct?
We approved the
$25,000
for the police cruiser, yeah.
Right, but we
no
didn't
weapons.
Do, the, we did one, we didn't
so
do
So everything
two.
Up right. to the service was already...
What page are we on?
Right.
19.
Right.
We could afford. So everything up on
everything
now.
Everything that's in here we can afford.
Everything now.
Well, the only thing we did, basically, was that car. Because
Everything else was pretty much.
Because for the fire department, the medic unit was already approved last year, so we have no choice but to pay for it this year. So we're down to.
Are we paying via lease or are we paying?
I'm not sure yet, because it depends.
So that makes a big difference, though.
If you end up going out for notes, we can maybe put that as part of that. We could do a lease.
Well, whatever.
But it was chosen to be that way.
I seem to remember spreading that out.
We did.
That was the plan.
That was the plan when we approved it.
Last year it was put in, the last time you purchased one in 2010, it was put into a note, or a bond issue.
It was put into a note first.
Where's the bond? Okay, let's see what it said.
Okay, so.
I didn't see it.
So.
So John was to come with this, with your number one, because we don't think we have.
We originally approved it going into a note for 5 years.
Right, I remember it was short.
And then they rolled it into that bond for 30, and I have no idea why.
We have, John, not to put you on the spot, but I think the only thing we had talked about potentially was that infamous skid steer with its attachments, or whatever you call it.
Yeah.
Which we could get for 0% financing.
And the reason for that was for the roads.
Yes.
To be able to do road work.
There were two steers, by the way.
There were two.
And there were two options on the table.
Right.
Right.
One was we could pay for it outright, which was.
$76,000, I think it was.
It was $46,000.
That was for the, but then is that.
As for the skid steer, yeah.
And then the add-ons were 20.
Then with the add-ons, it was just under 21,000.
Right.
So it was 75.
I got a phone call just before the meeting started from up the rep with John Deere, because this is the only one we'll reach out to right now before we go out for other bids. They believe they can finance the attachments, but he could not guarantee me a percentage rate. They're guesstimating 5 to 6. He was contacting his finance department. They'll try to get something together for us in writing, but they won't do a 0% on the attachments.
How much were the attachments? 21?
21,000. Just under 21,000. 20,787.57.
So the thought was it was.
So we could pay for the attachments and still finance.
It was like 75, right?
Okay.
What was
but now you had come back with that the skid steer itself could be financed at 0%, which is unreal.
And then isn't there a second skid steer?
Yes. Yeah, there's a track skid steer also the rest for the parks, working in the walking trails.
Is that going to be financed
0%? That could be financed at 0% as well.
And how much is that one?
That one would be $1,098.19.
No, how much was the total for that?
The total amount?
Yeah.
$52,713.
Yeah, that was
for the
pretty,
track.
Yeah.
So that one didn't need any attachments.
And it's financed.
No,
it's financed over what period, John?
48 months.
Okay, so 4 years. So
one's going to be used specifically. The track one is going after the parks.
So
the other
choice,
one's going to be on the road.
Right, a choice on the table. One, do we give them any? If we do, which one do we give them? And I know you're going to ask for both, but which one? You know, if it's Santa Claus coming to your door, which one do you absolutely, absolutely need?
The road one.
The road ones, right?
The road.
I hate to say, because we're making tough choices.
How often?
No, if we go.
Hold on. How often do you see the 0%? Like, is that something that you see regularly that we've got?
This is my first time.
So,
I mean, last
I mean,
finance
does anyone
I did
know
trips,
that answer?
No, that was just like.
Is this like a good deal that we're getting 0%?
I think.
But wait a minute. That's the other part of the discussion. Do we go for two? If we go for two, do we pay by amount right, or do we do the lease,
do
not the lease, but
finance,
the purchase
right?
at
well,
0%?
The present value of money tells you that, right?
So we buy them for over 4 years.
Yeah.
$24,000 a year.
And that's
can I mention this too? Last year, when we went in for the trucks and the loader, we were given a top dollar amount of $525,000.
Right.
We went out for multiple bids. We came in and saved just over $91,000.
Right.
So if we did
with
both.
That,
if we
is
did
that available in some way, shape, or form for us to.
But if we did the skid steer and the truck, right, isn't it?
And this could be lower too. Catch
okay.
up also by looking
but,
at it.
So my thought process in Rhonda, and she's over here fastly doing her addition, if we did it where we'd have to pay the 21, we know we don't have a choice, and getting the skid steer without the attachments is basically worthless, correct? Okay. So we'd have to pay 21 in cash, 22 in cash, and then how much per month if we bought both?
Well, how
much
per
annually?
For
$11,500
annually. $24,678. Is only the skid, right?
$24,678 a year.
Yeah.
Okay.
For both.
Which is for zero interest.
$24,700 for both.
How much?
$24,700.
So if we're going to do both, then we'd need 21 plus 25 approximately.
You'd need a total of 45,700.
What do you have in here now?
Because how long do you think it'd be before you even see this? If we said you were going to do this and we blessed it, how long does it take you to get it?
Better be here.
Relatively quick, because they're looking, they're changing out the models now, because the government has issued now with the emissions that they're requiring units to go to DEF.
Oh, really?
The equipment that our trucks do, our loader has that system. The loader that we need for the road repavings meets the criteria. They stopped all production of their current models right now, and they're building them, switching them over to DEF. That cost will go up. While they have them now, without, is when we should be jumping on this to get these things. Because the cost will go up once they stop production of what they have now, which they already did.
Are these contract?
Yes, state contract.
If we put the 46 into the capital, what's our total capital going to be this year?
Yeah, the other thing, the only reason I asked the question about timing is, you know, we say 46 based on, is that a year?
Yes.
Yes.
So we know.
No.
That's for this year.
It's for this year. Next year would be 24/7 for the two payments. You have two payments.
Right.
The two skids, right. Your payments for the next 3 years after that.
But is the 46 for both things for a year or for 8 months? Or
it's for the whole year.
For the rest of the year.
Okay, so it's not going to be as much because we won't get it to.
Right, yeah.
Do we begin the payment the month after we get it, or is there, we need to find that out. I mean, we'll put it in for the whole year, but I think there's, you know, how when you go out and buy something, your first payment is for like so many days, 60 days.
45,700.
Yeah, because it's going to be a negative.
Can I buy my car for 0%?
Are we paying monthly on these, or are we just paying annually?
Usually pay monthly.
Okay.
This one, if it's a lease.
They want monthly?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, he had said that it was a monthly, it's 0%. So, Rhonda.
Yes, ma'am.
The number would be, for the skid steer attachments is 22, if I round up.
Well, we said 21.
21 if I round up. And the cost, drum roll, for buying both, it's 0%.
45,700. That's assuming we pay a full year.
For the whole year.
Yes. Or for 1 year.
That's for 1 year.
And then next year, it would be 24/7.
Right, because we're buying the additional pieces.
We're paying cash.
Okay. Questions on the skid steer / truck?
What's the total cost?
So
if
I...
What's the total capital this year with the skid steer and the attachments?
Let's see. 18.
I don't know if you could repeat the question and the answer for the gentleman.
I'm just trying to be able to get these.
Having the sidebar. That way everybody hears the same number.
Okay, so the capital expenditures would increase to 864. $435.
And that's this number down here you just increased?
Yes. And we would probably have to increase the transfer from the general fund to 401 to help cover.
What is that transfer going to be? And what is that going to do to the general fund?
That would be 45.
If I took the whole thing out of the general fund, we would then change the general fund carryover, would be reduced to 541,375.
Do we need to take that out of general fund?
Well, you only have right now. Without the skid steers, we have 26,057 as the carryover.
No, I'm not talking about general fund. I'm talking about
capital.
The capital carryover. I'm just thinking there's a lot of 201 special funds. Can we spend any of those?
Because if you spend it out of 201, you're just going to have to increase the transfer from the general fund to that fund.
Well, we are getting a whole bunch of different types of taxes.
So the carryover then goes down to how much?
541,375.
Because it goes down by 45, right?
45,700.
And we're still in a balanced budget.
We are on a balanced budget.
We can't do anything else. I understand, but I'm just trying to ask these questions.
Right.
And so
the big stuff.
Get it on the table.
Yeah, $1 million.
All right, so what are we in? What are we talking about in capital? I know we're not doing the big stuff, but what are we proposing in capital right now?
I think the only thing you had in capital, correct me, Honda, was those things that are in comfort.
I'm asking.
We didn't, well, we answered that at the Capitol. We only put in what was encumbered. We didn't put anything new.
271 is 10,000. I added 10,000, and that's for engineering fees for finishing whatever he has to do.
All right. 135
135,000 is that invoice for
got it.
The specialized. The dog warden, for whatever reason, has always been paid out of that, and I left it because it's such a small amount, but...
But it shouldn't be paid out of capital.
It's been always paid out of capital.
That is true.
You can see the last couple of years, so
that
I kind of just estimated based on...
Yeah. I left it where it was.
Where it was,
it won't
yes.
make any difference. It's small.
We still got to spend it no matter which
EPA
side we take
compliance.
It from. Okay, keep going.
We could
the
change.
EPA compliance, that's per the engineer.
The
which
land,
we have no choice.
Right. The land acquisition is the right-of-way, which we are getting reimbursed from ODOT, so that's included in revenue, but I had to add it as an expense.
All right. So,
okay,
what,
so
that's the right-of-way. Stuff and Puff? Is that the...
Speedway, the
okay.
Speedway and what's the other... I was
Puff and Stuff.
Do you want to just...
And then
expand on that, Rhonda, because I want to hear that.
The 22,025 was for Speedway,
yes.
right of way, and
yeah.
then there's another 100 and some thousand for Cipriani.
Right.
Yeah.
Is that Puffin?
And
the,
yeah. And the, yes, that's what he's talking about.
And we're
about.
Getting reimbursed from ODOT, so
okay.
it's included in revenue.
All right.
And I have to show it as an expense. So.
Right, I understand that.
Okay,
right.
keep going.
25,000
but
for
it's not
person.
From our general fund. It's
keep
down.
Going.
It's from 401, yes. Road repairs, the crack seal that was done last year, and we have the invoice for now.
Okay.
And then the loader was paid for last year, $146,000, and then the fire medic. The fire medic could potentially go down to, like, we finance that in a lease.
Well,
okay.
I've got until August to figure out how to.
We do not need to then, if we were planning this, it would seem logical that we would go to 60. Finance it because
right.
the interest rates are so low,
right.
there'd be no reason
right.
to.
So leave it here like you have.
Right,
it.
So that number
I don't
could potentially be 20,000.
Divide that either by 4 or 5
right.
years.
Okay.
Right,
but we leave it there, but we
yeah,
don't touch it
math.
Until we know
right.
we've got the
Six
money.
6 years would be
well,
30.
Then,
correct.
Mayor, there was
six
one other thing.
I don't know if they do those in.
Well, you
banks.
Know, I kicked you it in my head. Real
there was
20,
one other
7,
thing
5.
That was identified 75. That I don't think. I think it's a wash, but you've got to explain. And that was the 160,000 for the parks, for the lights,
yes.
fields,
yeah.
blah, blah, blah.
What that
can you
is,
explain that?
Go ahead. You want to go ahead?
Yeah, I mean, this was monies that we received back that was put into escrow for Two Club Golf that we received from Two Club Golf
right.
for taxes that we didn't have to actually spend.
Right.
So therefore, I feel that any dollars that came out of the parks need to go directly back into the parks. And therefore, what I'm recommending is that the sign coming into Longwood Park, that be for the sign for the base,
mm-hmm.
also for the lighting at the ball fields, for the dugout concrete, and the remainder of money goes towards starting to continue to improve the pathways through the woods there, because that seems to be a high priority for a lot of people that walk the parks. So it's monies that were generated from the parks going back into the parks.
It was generated from Two Club when they failed
it's
to pay.
It's the property tax.
It's not when they failed. It was held in abeyance, if you remember.
Right. They were setting it aside.
Right.
I remember. And it wasn't actually Two Club. It was their
right,
successor.
Right, until the case
windmill.
Was decided.
So there's not actually an account that has that money in there?
Yes, there is.
Yes.
It's Fund 206.
Yes. We have the funds, and we receive
we can do...
And
are we restricted on what we can do with these funds?
No, what I think we're going to reimburse. We're putting it in Fund 204, which is Parks and Recreation. So we're going to pay for the dugout and stuff like that out of 204. I have to show in 206 a reimbursement to Fund 204.
But the important question from our standpoint is this is if we decide this is the way to go and it makes sense to me is it's budget neutral.
Yes.
That noted
yes.
And we can start making some improvements to the park, and I particularly think the trails would be a great thing. People
well, I think everybody agrees
and
with that.
And the 160, your goal
ago.
Is to use that for dugouts, trails, and lighting.
Lighting in the ball
digital, the digital
are
sign.
Are we talking about lighting at night now? Because there's always been some...
There's
been
a lot
so
of hostility.
Only be event lighting, so in the event that they have a game that goes into the night, that the lights would go on. But you have to remember, when we built that square tower, all of the undergrounds were put in for all of the lighting out there, and all the power was put into that building. So all that infrastructure is already in place.
Are we talking one field, two fields?
All four fields, I'm hoping to light them up.
Oh, no kidding.
That's, we'll see if that's pretty expensive.
Well, we do as many as you can, but you wanted the
I'll do as much as I can, but I have ways and thoughts of how to.
Well, they were expecting huge numbers.
Why don't you go me to hold a flash?
The cars, you gotta get the cars.
If there's 40 of us out there with those big lights.
But you have to see that in Fund 206, you're gonna see an expenditure of 160, which is the reimbursement to 204.
But it's the money we've got.
And then you have to see the expenditure out of 204.
But it's the money we receive from Two Club.
Yes.
Well, the money that's been hanging around from Two Club. So going back to the parks is very logical, because it's the park that generated it.
Right.
It's the park that, we get some things, some good things out of that development. And then as long as we put some money towards the trails, I don't have a problem, because the trails are just atrocious.
And we have a rental agreement with Windmill, Two Club,
right.
That if they extended past 2016, we could potentially get continuous rent from them, and additional money. So
it's up this year?
I think it's up this year.
Yeah, I think we probably have to set the...
Mark and I are working on, he's actually working on trying to contact them, because they still owe us money from 2011.
Who owes us?
The Two Club people.
The original.
Not Windmill.
Yeah. But not Windmill.
Well, I don't know.
Okay.
Yeah, you don't know the difference. But
you're going to be in discussions with Windmill to keep them, I hope, because...
I think it's a great asset for us. I think we need to continue to have them. I think it's a recreational tool there that's up there, and I would hate to see the driving range. I think that's probably one of the bigger money makers.
Oh, my gosh.
Well, that's the only thing that's making money
that
there.
That thing is crowded to the nth degree. And then the kids program, because I had talked to them about the first club or whatever it is. There's a kids golf thing that I got involved with through Firestone, and they hooked up with them, so they now do kids. They really have gone after it, but I don't want to own the golf course back that I have to maintain.
Well, that's the
thing.
Yeah, that's where it would go, though, if they decide not to.
Well,
we don't find someone.
To be the bearer, that driveway needs a lot of work, too. That driveway's in disrepair.
So
if we finance the fire medic, let's just say over 4 years,
yes.
I could potentially add back a little $217,000 to Fund 401, which then means I wouldn't have to transfer money from the general fund to cover the skid steers.
Well, leave it there until you get the final.
Yes.
And then if you get the final, we put it back in general, because we're going to be back together again in a couple months to say, how we doing? Is there anything else we can't do?
So am I adding the skid steers, the two skid steers financed, and then the add-ons?
Over
am
4 years?
Yes.
The add-ons this year.
The skid and the truck?
The whole skid steers, one has tracks.
Yeah, one's on tracks.
Off-road.
Okay, you better see some poles fixed real fast.
The one in the tracks has to go into the parks,
especially
because you otherwise can't do those trails.
Right.
Are we passing the budget then as we see this exhibit here, or after you make the changes?
As amended, yes. I'll make the changes. But I don't know if I can make the changes.
Well, there's only one.
I understand.
How many changes are there? There was one.
Oh, I'm actually just adding the skid steers right now, right?
Yeah.
And adding the, we're not
doing
the certificate, so.
You're going to add that that $19,000.
But that's to revenue. That's not, has nothing to do with tonight's budget. We're only doing,
so,
this is just
I'm just trying to understand if we're
passing it as,
this, or as just a giant, so much to each, department. So we're doing the detail. That's all I want.
No, we're not doing the detail. The ordinance is going to look like this.
That's what I want to know.
Yeah. It's in total the same line items, but it's not by line item.
Let me see. Well,
yep.
Why don't we pass it by line?
Because that's a painful 55 amendments last year.
So
what we did by line.
I understand.
It's by personal services
really
and then other expenditures for a total. So this total will then agree to the total that is in there.
We're going back to the way we used to do the budget.
No, I understand.
Well, actually, that's not true. We changed it at one point from all the detailed line items to those summary items.
I'm just suggesting that we should do it
as
the line items we did last year. I understand that it's an inconvenience, but I think that, you know, it helps us with tracking.
Which one are we approving? Well, we still get the monthly report that you can track by department. That's where we kept finding things for 90%, 100%. We had to go put money in.
0%.
If you don't do it by line item, the department head goes back to the way it was, where they are responsible for all their line items. If they find, and I'll bring up the jailers, the meals. If John found he's at 90% against for meals and needs money, he looks within his own purse to see, can I care for that without having to ask for any more money? I think it puts the responsibility back to where it belongs, which is department heads. We write the check. And yes, we look at the monthly reports. And yes, I looked at every monthly report and be the one writing the list of things that had bit the budget. But they had no capability to move money within their own department, which, you know, they're hired as a department head for a reason. So, Mayor, unless you have something else,
I'd like to make a comment on that because I think that is completely off course of the reality. The department heads are always responsible for budget execution. I mean, there's no question about that.
I don't disagree with that.
And if they, all that's happening is we pass it in detail, then, and the that doesn't absolve the department head of managing their budget. All it says is if they have, they're going off course, they need to come and tell us they're going off course, and we'll make an adjustment. Most of the time, people should know, as a department head, exactly in detail where they're going to be at any point in the year. We had some changes that were down to the, you know, $300 level, and I don't think we needed to do that. I think they could have been done quarterly, and we would never have gotten there. So all I'm saying is, this way, we know exactly how the expenditures are tracking to the total detailed budget. Otherwise, we're getting the financial reports, but we don't know. Then we got to figure out where did they move it and why did they move it. And I
but
just think
it's within their own department.
Well,
so the bottom line is they have 100 grand.
Well,
and within
that's what
their
we're
department,
saying.
They moved 300. Why do you really care if there's still 100 grand?
Well, what I'm saying is this. We might care if they're moving from a line item that we don't think should be moved from, or we have a different priority.
But what if it's the department? That's the department.
Well,
that's
no,
decision.
It is not, ma'am.
Please, it's yours. You don't run that department.
But
how
don't
can you
run
say
it?
To John Golden,
you know,
you can't pay it? At the state level,
do you think that the governor gets a line item budget? No.
Well, no, he has somebody tracking all of that for him. That's right.
Does the county have a line item?
They give him a budget and they say, please stay within your budget, as every government body that I know, and I've never done a line item budget in all the years that I was mayor, and nor previous mayors that I know of in other communities.
I am just saying there's nothing terrible about this.
This is a way to just tie the hands of the administrator. If you want to tie the hands of the administrator, that's what happened with the past administration.
They had no hands.
Every time they needed to do something, they had to come running back to council. It made life miserable. I mean, it's just not the way you operate a city.
The mayor gets elected
by the people.
Yes.
You're a legislative body. You give me a budget, you say you got to operate within this budget. And I say, okay, I'll operate within this budget. Give me the dollars, I'll operate within
that's what we're
budget.
Talking about here.
So I am.
Can do it money.
But
yes.
Line item budgets are not what is
well,
what
that's
is
an
intent.
Opinion that you want to have. You want to have more flexibility.
And you can do that.
And
exactly.
We want
and I do.
To
and exactly
I understand
right.
that's true. That doesn't mean necessarily that the council shouldn't have a line item budget.
I understand how you think about that, and I think if you were sitting in this chair, you certainly wouldn't want.
Well,
a line
no,
item.
I am not concerned about it because the plan would be to lay it out. Now, we've got a very squishy budget at this point because we don't know this, we don't know that.
We're all elected officials here, and we all represent the people.
We got 800,000 more this year. And somehow in the operating without even worrying about transfers.
But we've explained that. So
well, no, we haven't.
Yes, we
you've said what you've said. I'll say that.
Okay,
but
let's put this back to Rhonda is going up to make the changes. So when we're done with the, don't we?
Right.
We're going to the revenue discussion because we do have to talk about, I think it became evident we have no way to create 800,000 unless we don't hire it. Period. So one of the things we started talking about, which the mayor had broached the subject when he had proposed the quarter percent. Thank you. Thank you. That's exactly what we need, tax reduction. So Rhonda provided us, you should have two things that look like this. One says various possibilities for August ballot. And then the other one says safety forces and service per home versus property taxes. So Mayor, since Rhonda went upstairs to update the budget for us, can you speak to, in whichever one you want to speak to, tell us which page, Ron, so we can follow.
Yeah, I'm trying to find that document in itself, because I know she just provided that today. Rhonda.
Tell her, keep on going.
You are? I have it. If you want one.
Here it is.
Are you looking for this?
You got it.
Is this one right here?
Yeah, it's 142.
Okay, thank you, I got it.
No, you got it.
It's also, and the one, I think it's probably in front of it. Let me see.
Yes, this one.
Yeah, it's this one. Yeah, it's that one. And then there's, right behind it is probably this one that she gave us tonight, so.
Well, first of all, if you go to the sheet that was, that has a, at the very top, it says safety forces and services per home versus the property tax. What we essentially did there is we took what it cost us to operate the police department in 2015 with dispatch service, and we put a total of that, same with fire and dispatch service for their portion of the dispatching. Then we put the service department, and then we came up with a total for all of that, which comes out to $9,959,426.37.
Police, fire, and service.
So you see that?
Mm-hmm.
And so then what we did is we said, okay, homes within our city are 4,545 homes. That's how many we have.
Mm-hmm.
So we divided that into the total operating cost of police, fire, and service, which then gave us a figure of $2,191.29. You may be asking why we did this, because it's so often that we are trying to figure out what it cost us to operate in front of an individual home in the city. So then we applied a cost of what it cost to pave in front of an individual home. And that cost came out to approximately $800 for 100 foot of frontage in front of a home. And that's just one side of the street, by the way. So that total cost to maintain in front of that home is $2,991.29. So then we put the property tax received from an average $150,000 home, which is an 8.9 mils, and that is about $467.25.
That's what we get today.
That's what we get today.
Okay.
For every single home. That is an average of $150,000 home, which is the average in some of the older neighborhoods.
Some of the newer areas, it's more. Some
it's
of the older.
Obviously in the older and newer areas, yeah. It's
a median definitely. Number of some kind?
This is a median number. We
so
plugged in a median number.
Okay.
So the difference is approximately $2,524 that it cost us per home to provide those services. Okay. So then, when you take the $4,545 and you multiply that into that $2,524, because you're now backing out the actual tax that you're getting by way of real estate, mm-hmm. it shows that the city is underfunded of about $11,471.75. $11,471,775.12. Now the income tax that's collected in the city, which is then
we actually applied that, which is a $7,514,806.94. That shows that there is still remaining underfunded of $3,956,968. The reason we want to show you these numbers is so that you can get an idea of how much the city is subsidizing each and every home of the city, because we have not had a real estate increase since the 60s. We're essentially at the same number that we were back in the 60s on the real estate side. So what does drive our engine? Our engine is driven by the income tax dollars and the payroll tax, which is the $7 million. But you can see that we're still underfunded by that almost close to $4 million. So then she wanted to show, or at least Rhonda put together, that if we had to increase the millage, for instance, from where we're currently at to almost double, that would generate, that would be a 15.1 mils, that would be $792.75. Would be the additional cost, and the difference would be $325.50, the difference in the increase, which then would bring us down to we'd still have an undershot of unfunding remaining if you go all the way to the bottom line of $2,447,570.
So is this saying to me if I double the millage?
Yeah, if you even double the millage, you're still going to be underfunded.
Okay.
So then we thought about, well, let's look at then the other aspect of that. That would be, let's look at the other various possibilities. Let's talk about a 25% increase in the income tax that generates approximately $1 million annually. Talk about 50%. That would be $2 million, obviously. Talk about a 0.25% reduction in tax credit from 100 to 75. That would generate approximately $1,265,047. A 50% would be obviously double that, which would be $2,530,095. And then the 6.2 mil levy, if you put that on, that would generate $2.5 million.
Now, if I did the increase in income tax, let's take the first one, 25%.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't give credit for anything above two. That's what the one is, 1 million. That's with no credit for.
That's still 100% reciprocity of the credit. You still
up
have
to 2.25, or only up to two.
Well, this is currently. If you're asking what we're, give me your question because
I'm not confused. On this 25% increase, right now I have 100% reciprocity.
Correct.
And I can't say that word.
Reciprocity.
Thank you. Altogether, I can't say that word. So up to 2%, I have that. If I increase by 25%, are you also going to increase?
No, the credit still remains at 100%. So
at 2%?
At 2%.
Yeah. So
okay.
Thank you. Just a question, and you pointed that out. That doesn't make these numbers don't make sense, and that may to me. I'm not being critical, because if we're increasing the income tax but not increasing the credit. You say we're only getting a million, but if we're decreasing the credit by 25%, which affects less taxpayers, it's a greater number, 1.2 million. That I don't think that makes sense.
You're looking at this these are just showing you what those numbers would generate if you were to do each and every one of those, or just one or two.
I understand.
So are you looking at them on an individual basis?
Yeah, I'm looking at, okay, let's say we're going to increase taxes by income tax by 0.25%.
Right.
That's $1 million. Okay, I'll accept it. But then you say, well, okay, let's don't do that. Let's reduce the tax credit from 100% to 25%, which is a 25% or a 0.25 reduction.
Right. Mm-hmm. So 75% instead of 100.
Right, but that creates an extra $265,000, but not everybody who pays taxes works outside of the city. That doesn't. That only affects those people. That doesn't make sense. It should be the same or
no.
Let me. Yeah. I'll see if I can answer it for you, because
right.
It's actually you're getting
you're paying 0.5 to make up, because it, 75% would your the city would reimburse 1.5, so you would have to make up to 2%. So you'd actually be paying more, and it's less people that work outside the city. So that's why the number is different. Does that make sense?
Right. Well, that's why I'm saying that, since less people work outside of the city,
but
let me finish.
Paying more.
What do you mean they pay more?
They're paying 0.5%.
No, they are. Some of them are paying 2%.
No, they make up. It's just be 0.5%, because the reciprocity would be to 1.5.
Yeah, so I'm paying.
And they would have to pay to 2.
Right. I'd
so
be paying 2% to Cleveland, right, as I do today, but I'd also be paying 0.25% or 0.5% to Macedonia, because I've lost the credit that goes against my 2. Right now, I get a credit for 2. Tomorrow, I only get a credit for 3/4 of that. So I still got to pay Cleveland, but now I'm paying more. But
when it's 2, a quarter is 50. Is that, it's 50, 100, 150, 200. So when you take away a quarter, you're at 1.5.
Yeah, I think he understands what you're saying. I just,
so you're actually making up more.
Well, let's explain it for Dave. Hold on. Are you okay, Dave?
No, I'm fine with myself. No, I'm fine. Let's just go on.
Well, let me just kind of elaborate a little bit more here. The only reason we put these various scenarios together is so you can see the various options. These are just options. There's 25%, 50%, 25% reduction, 50% reduction, 6.2 mil levy. These are just points that I'm bringing to the table so you can have an idea what we need to do. Now, if you said, how can we attack $20 million? How do you attack $20 million in road repair that you need to do?
Said, I mean, $20 million a year, $20 million over 20 years.
Well, $20 million of roads you need to repair right now in the city. So, I mean, how do you attack $20 million in roads and get them?
We're not going to do it in 1 year.
I know you're not going to
have an overall plan.
But the idea would be is you got to have a source of revenue that's being generated so you can help retire debt. So you may not take the entire, let's assume that you had $2 million coming in, flowing in. You may take and say, okay, we're going to set aside $500,000 a year just to do our ongoing maintenance of all of our streets, meaning we're going to go out and do a sealing, a crack sealing, and what have you, and we're going to take the other $1.5 million and we're going to put them into a note form and go out and do X amount of roads that we can possibly do.
Obviously.
And roll them over every 5 years. Now that may be how we have to tackle this, because we're never going to have enough money to take down $20 million. At one given time.
So what's your, if I can just ask, of the options presented there, if you had your choice, which would be the one you would prefer?
Well, here's what I'm thinking is that we obviously need to get ahead of the curve, and it's going to take the city a long time to get there. We probably should have been doing this probably 10 years ago.
We should have been.
We should have been implementing this type of program. My suggestion is that we go after the 0.5%, with a drop-off of 0.25% after a 5-year period or after a 3-year period, whatever we think the number could work, and maintain 0.25% from now until the cows come home for nothing more than earmarked money for roads. Because otherwise you're never going to get caught up in this city. You're going to constantly be chasing your tail. And
it's
a problem.
Let me just say a couple things about this. The 7.5 million that you're looking at here is at 2%, we're collecting around 8.4 to 8.6 million. That's what we're collecting. Right now, we have funneled 1 million of that towards the recreation center building and the associated stuff. That's going to go away. We can choose that to go away, and we can say, okay, so the 0.25% that was going to the buildings here, which is basically, if you add together what the debt was on the rec center building and the debt on this building, it was about $1,065,000. And if you say, okay, we're going to take 0.25%, we're going to dedicate it to capital improvements, majority on roads, some other things will be done also, like at the, in the parks and rec, and also some things will be done in stormwater. Hopefully, we'll get something from this NEORSD deal. Otherwise, it's kind of like we can't. What I'm saying is, we're not going to correct this issue with anything that we can do that makes sense here. We've got $80,000 per household income. That's the median income in Mashpee. We, I believe, needed to have redirected money towards the roads a long time ago. We didn't do that because of the debt we had on these two buildings. We are now going to be able to redirect money. We also need to reduce costs, and let me point out where. Our healthcare costs are huge relative to the private sector. They are extremely high, as you know and you've acknowledged. If we don't fix that, that is going to suck up everything that we have fairly shortly.
I hope to have that.
If we can do the combination of things, I think we will have enough money for.
You'd already said you were.
I'm working on that. I think there's a significant amount of money that we're going to be able to save.
Well, what are we talking now, logically?
Well, first of all, I think we're going to have to pull away from the county, to be very honest with you. That's $100,000 administrative fee we're paying them right now.
That's right.
So that's got to come off. That's.
Well, we have to figure out if we can get a better deal, that's
for
sure.
Well, that's why we're going to do the RFPs. Back in the day when I first took office, the first thing I did was we went to a stop-loss situation where we had an insurance policy. We participated up to maybe $150,000 back then, as I remember. We saved the city a ton of money by doing that. And that's the way we need to probably go back to.
So you're looking at health care, which we already knew. You said that you can't do anything for this year.
No, it's
because we're locked down.
We're locked down. Yeah,
that's right. So the discussion point on the table is this is to start us thinking, no matter, you know, we keep saying we'll just take the money from the rec center, but the rec center has an aggressive program to put that back out for renewal. So do we say too bad, too sad to the rec center?
No.
And count those dollars into ours, and then you do no upkeep on that rec center, you do no additions to that rec center. At some point, that rec center will have to close.
I think it's important to note that we're listening to the residents, too. And a lot of the things and the surveys that have gone out have talked about the future of that rec center. I know in the last meeting, there's a gentleman who, he made it somewhat of a good point from his perspective of, you know, why are we paying for recreation in the city? And it actually got me thinking, you know, it made a lot of sense, but there are still a lot of people that want that. So from the surveys and everything I heard, and we all, you were just in the election, a lot of things I heard were about that right there. So to take the money away from that at this point means that we're going to let that thing become stagnant.
No, it doesn't.
Yes, it does, because what has happened in that building, look at the parking lot, look at the roof, and the leak.
Hold on, stop, let me finish.
You know, a lot of the equipment in there. Remember, Angela came to us and said, I need equipment to operate, and the reason people go there is to use the equipment to exercise, and she didn't even have equipment for people to exercise on. Wow. So we can't keep operating on a shoestring on something like that where our objective there is to break even. We're not trying to make money. It's not our objective. It's something that we provide to the community that they have told us over and over and over that they want. Yes. So to tell me right now that you're not going to listen to them is a little troubling to me, because I know Kevin's sitting on the board, I sit on the board, and Jan's on the board. This is something that has gone on for years and years and years. And not saying my own personal opinion, I'm not even interjecting it at all. But what the people are saying is they want that to continue. I've heard more about phase 2 and 3 than anything.
Well, everybody's heard this. We
have heard that, and that's what they've asked for.
Well, could
so
I then respond
should,
to this?
If because, I could ever finish, I would love
well,
to let
you
talk.
All right. But you know what I'm saying? You've said this.
All right, Kevin, do you have something before we go back to
I think that you guys know my point of view on it, that if we put it to the vote and it passes, let's word it right. I like the fact that we can write a levy that could be specific to an area that we want to address. It takes the politics out of it, because that money will go into those funds. Doesn't matter who's mayor, who's on council. Every year we know if the people want the roads fixed, well, in year 2020, there it is. In year 25, there it is. Same thing with the parks. You move forward or you stay stagnant.
No.
So essentially what's being said, Sylvia, if I could finish.
Okay.
is we don't want to go the way you're suggesting. So I'm speaking for him, because he just said it, I've said it now, Jan, I believe we've talked about it, and you felt that way, and I haven't gotten Dave's opinion yet.
Right. Here's, can I?
But we don't want to go that way.
Sylvia, let's let every person talk.
I'd like to hear Sylvia finish.
Okay, thank you.
Why, no, because when she takes up 45% of the time, each person should get some time. Your opinion is important.
I don't have an opinion right now, I'm deferring to Sylvia, then I will give you my opinion.
Okay.
Oh, I see.
Okay. Now.
No, you don't, because.
Yes, I do. Go ahead,
Sylvia. I won't give you an opinion, but I'll still.
Don't give
me
an opinion.
All right, all right. Could I just say this? You're putting a straw man here, which says we either do nothing to the rec center, or we dedicate $1 million to it annually.
Can I just let me interject.
Okay. All right.
We just said that about $1 million needs to go to the roads, correct?
Yeah.
Per year.
More than a million.
Well, minimum. More than a million. So if we want to put a levy for that replaces the one now for 0.25%, how much money is that going to raise? I'm being told it's for $1 million a year.
Right.
So even if it says capital improvements, it can say whatever it wants, and there's $1 million of roads repair every year that's going to suck that fund up.
Right.
So guess who gets left out in the cold is the rec center.
Hold on the assumptions here for
a second. I'm just trying to.
I understand. You're positing that we have to have $1 million dedicated to a road bond annually. That has not been demonstrated. We've had some discussion of it, but it hasn't been demonstrated.
That has been.
Well, that's what Joe was saying.
That's what Nick Feeney said.
Let me finish what I said. Please.
How much money did we spend last year? You made a very provocative statement.
Wow.
How much money did we spend on roads?
We didn't even touch a minute of the roads.
Well, we spent money on roads. The majority of what we spent on roads was because of the ODOT situation with 82 and 27.
Take them out. How many roads did we do?
Listen.
A ninth of the roads that need to be done. So
I understand.
You're coming about $1 million a year as an Akron.
But let's just let me finish, please, and then everybody can jump all over me.
No, we're not trying to jump all
yes,
over you.
Yes, you are.
No,
and let me finish.
I'm just trying to say
just
that.
Let me finish.
I'll be honest with you. I've
okay,
never heard anyone, not say.
Let's stop.
I have never heard anyone not say that it needs $1 million per year. That's the number that I've heard for the last year.
Well, you may have heard it, Kevin. Hearing something.
So what's the number that you have?
Hearing something.
What's the number that you have that we need to fix the roads?
I think we need to look at $600,000 annually forever, okay? We have a $200,000 probably we're going to need for the recreation center and the park system to do it annually. We have stormwater issues, although we're going to have additional money from NEORSD. We have to make choices about things. That's what budget's about. And no one is saying that we're going to do nothing to the recreation center at all. I've heard this. But when you tell people, look at all this great stuff we can do, and
absolutely.
You say, but we're not going to fix roads for any of that money, so you're going to have to pay us another 0.25% for the money that you want on the roads, instead of saying to them, here's some choices, you can have this.
We're going to give them some choices, to vote yes or to vote no.
Well, that's not a choice, though. You're not
putting it on the ballot and let the majority decide.
Okay, so if we don't get the money, then what do? We have a recreation center, we're going to have $1 million, but they don't want to spend any more money on roads. See, this, what we need to do is really talk about what it is we actually need and how can we front load a bond for roads, because we have a backlog of roads that we've not touched for 30 years.
Can I ask you a question? I don't want to, just being new at this, where did you come up with that number, $600,000 for the roads?
Well, I was looking at what do we need to do to front load a bond that would go over a decade on this area.
What do you think you're going to do with $600,000?
Well, we're going to pay $600,000 annually. It'll be a heck of a lot more than what we've been doing for the last 30 years.
Yeah,
right?
It's a heck of a lot more, but you don't understand. People are out there
crying for their roads
to be repaved.
Is Sylvia suggesting that we get a bond for $10 million or something so we can start right now and we pay
right.
it off? Over a certain amount, but we're not going to have to pay. I'm just.
Yeah.
That does make sense.
However, the roads that we did last year were over
Yes, but that's...
600, that doesn't include 82. I'm just counting the B streets and the two streets that we promised.
The finance director had a comment.
It was only 600 grand. So now I've lost all the money. How do I do the rest of the roads?
Right.
Well, here's the thing, what you're saying, 600 grand over 20 years generates $12 million. This man sitting here telling us we have 20 million plus another 10 behind, so that's $30 million. I'm not in the favor of digging a huge hole of debt right here. I think we have an opportunity, and I have heard from a lot of people that said, if you earmark something for the roads and stormwater, I'm in support of it.
Right.
And I think that's what's on the table today. 600,000 is not going to cover it. I think the other thing we're forgetting about is, you know...
That's what you're talking about,
but
Nick.
We want to ease some of the strain on our general fund. We keep forgetting the same thing, and we sit at this table every single year running the same problem. One example, a ladder truck for the fire department is $1 million. Mm-hmm. How are we going to pay for that?
We're not.
You know, emergency comes up on the roof. Parking lot needs paved out here, a couple hundred thousand. Where does this money come from? It's just not going to fall from the sky. I don't want to dig a hole of debt. That's my only thing I'm after. I understand where you're coming from. I respect your opinion. But I am not in favor of being the federal government and digging a hole of debt.
Well, we're not digging a hole
of
debt.
That's a huge hole of debt. Doesn't even solve the problem, because what you're saying generates $12 million, mm-hmm, and does not cover the $20 million we have existing. 20 years from now, that $12 million, $30 million in roads turns into $60 million.
Well,
what are we going to do then? We're going to pass the buck down the line to people and say, hey, here's a line of debt.
You're making all kinds of assumptions in your statement. First,
can I ask a question?
Let's let Dave has not had a chance, and now I think he's ready. So go, Dave, go.
No, I am not ready, but I know Rhonda wanted to address bonds, and she said I thought she said she had done some looking into it, and then she was slaughtered because she doesn't talk loud. So stand up for yourself, woman, and tell us the truth.
Right. What about bonds?
I contacted the underwriters that we used the prior bond. Mm-hmm. They are looking into various bond and note issue scenarios in $5 million increments, starting from $5 million to $20 million, looking at how much all the cost will be. I should have that next week.
Great.
Good.
Either way, there's not enough money to cover the projects, because even Don Sheehy had six roads at $1 million. We don't have that money.
We've got two road projects. We got two, the Sioux Culvert and the Guadalupe retention basin's $1 million.
Right. And then you've got Ledge Road potentially. So
yeah,
there's not enough money. So we have to generate additional dollars somehow on a ballot to be able to, if we do get notes, to be able to pay those notes off, or to at least start.
And getting projects shelf ready too.
Well, here's
can I ask you, Mayor, the timeline?
This is to open the door
for the discussion, guys, because we keep saying no, 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 and we keep coming back to, but we don't have that, and we talked about it last year, and we talked about the year before. We don't have an annual road program. If we were to go to the ballot, are you looking for August, since it would be lost in the November?
I think we need to do something immediately. I think that it's urgent. I mean, it's even if you were to take and say, okay, let's cut out everything else that we could cut out, you still wouldn't have enough money to put a dent
so
in what we have.
So your proposal is, hold on, I'm trying to find out what his proposal is before we rebut.
Well, my proposal is that we should go to the ballot. If we can go to an August ballot, get and put on either the quarter or the half percent with a drop off on the one quarter of it, I think that would be a good timing to do it and get it to the voters. And I think we need to explain to the voters why we're asking for what we're asking for, and the fact that we're earmarking the money and that we're not going after a real estate tax, because we don't want to crush everybody in this city.
So
we want it to be something that's coming from the majority of the people that are working in Macedonia.
So.
And when would an August ballot need to be? I'm sorry, Sylvia, these are questions that every meeting needs to know to try and understand our timeline.
I think that you have to have 90 days prior to the election.
Right.
So we're talking
June.
August, July, June, May. So we really need to get the discussion done before May.
May I make a comment on the August ballot? I understand August ballots is quicker, but I don't think it's going to create any income in this year. So I would propose a November ballot for a couple reasons. First reason is November ballot gets a bigger turnout. And certainly it'll get a big turnout because of a presidential election. And it might be overwhelming if Trump is the GOP nomination, God only knows. But anyways, that we'll put it, we'll stick, we'll set aside the presidential discussion. But also, a August ballot does cost the city money, which it will not cost there. So in that regard, I would express the opinion that I believe a November ballot is preferred.
And I'll tell you why I don't necessarily want to go to the November ballot. First off, the need is urgent. We need to do it now. Secondly, is that in November, we're going to have the schools that are going to be on for a real estate increase. Our chances then are going to be less than possible to get that through at that time. I think that the residents need to focus in on this, and they need to see the reward if they voted in place. So in my opinion, it's like, okay, if you give me $10, I'm going to give you something right back. I mean, we're going to do it. We're not going to mess around with this. Our time is of the essence. I mean, I don't...
But we're not going to generate income
this year. Right, that's correct.
I understand, but we can take debt with the understanding that we're generating dollars now, revenue. So you can take debt at that point.
If you did it in August, we'd have to be in May. How much is the cost for us to run an election? The only problem, and I'm going to say the problem I have, 68, right?
About 15,000.
Yes, that's right.
The problem I have...
I paid for it. I know. I paid for a little...
Oh, that's true.
He continues to bellyache about it, so I remember too.
Yeah. I'm not bellyaching. It was just a precedented issue that never taken place in the city's history. So that's all. I'm not bellyaching.
Now, the only problem I have with the November ballot date, to your point, yes, you get more voters, but does everybody remember to turn over the ballot? Because 9 times out of 10, these issues wind up on the back. Nobody pays attention. And when you have and there's going to be a lot on the ballot. If you look at your ballot yesterday, there's a lot of things to vote on.
I think
in
November's right.
The candidate world, let alone the issue world, I don't think you get the, you may get the turnout, but I don't think you get anybody mark them below president.
I don't, you know, in the past, these November ballots have, in election years, like the presidential year, are kind of full, but people will be paying attention if you're asking for an increase in taxes. They will be. So let me just complete what my thought here before I'm attacked again. I believe that we need, and you've just all said you want 0.25% to be dedicated to roads. I don't believe it should be just dedicated to roads. I believe it should be, however, substantially dedicated to roads. Nobody's talking about more than that. Then the question is, if we did that in August or November this year, then the question would be, the other 0.25% doesn't expire for the rec center until the middle of next year. And if at that point the decision is made by the voters that they want to add 0.25% to pay for the rec center, good for them, and we got the majority for that, that's fine. What I don't want to see is us pretending like this isn't going to cost us more money, when in fact it is going to cost them 0.25% more if you do what you're suggesting.
I say we have some town hall meetings about it, though.
Well, that's fine.
We've done before.
And explain to people this is the reason why.
This is
how much money it's going to generate. This is where it's going to go. Right. This is what it's going to do.
Right.
We did
Joe
those
likes
town
to talk.
Halls.
He can do the whole thing.
Well, we can all talk. Well, and the point is this.
Some of us shouldn't.
Wait a minute, Kevin. Just because you disagree doesn't mean that there is...
We all disagree. Well, I know that a majority disagrees, but we keep on going back to it. We all say we don't support that idea.
Well, then we have a difference of opinion.
Well, okay. So let's not keep on going back to it.
Well,
tonight.
That's all I'm saying. You explained it. You explained it on the floor 3 times. This is what you want. But this is not what everybody
else
wants.
Well, then, that's what I'll campaign
guys,
for, then.
Guys,
before we
ladies,
end, may
gentlemen,
ask one question.
No, we're rehashing the same comment. Do you now have a comment to make?
I have a question and a comment.
Okay.
But
you're the last person.
If I understand, part of the mayor's proposal is that there would be a reduction in credit for people who work outside of the city. Is that one of your proposals? Is that part of the proposal or not?
Dave, let me explain. What I put in front of you is nothing more than various options.
Okay, so
I'm not suggesting any one of those other than what I had stated, and that was to go to the ballot with a 0.5% increase with a drop-off date, which I'm not sure what that should be at this time. That's just my recommendation, so that we can gain a lot of ground quickly to do a lot of notes and roads. and then drop off a quarter of the half.
And so it's a temporary change in the credit.
Correct. Right. No, it's not a credit issue.
Okay, all right, that's fine. That's what I wasn't. My comment is, I don't think that we should, no matter what we do, I don't think we should mess around with the credit, the 2% credit, as it is.
No, I'm not suggesting it.
I know that, but that's been put on the table.
Yeah,
I just want to make, not. I'm not saying you're putting it on the table. I'm just saying a lot of the criticism that I've heard is that of people who work outside of the city of Macedonia, they feel that they should be treated equal. We shall be treated equal. I think that type of change, let me just finish, I'll be done, creates division among the populace. And for the record, I no longer work outside of the city. Last September, my office moved to the city, and so any increase, I'm going to pay full freight. So with that, I'm done with my comments.
Thank you.
Agree with you 100%.
Thank you. Yes, Mr. Molnar.
Other than an emergency situation.
Mr. Molnar, last comment.
I agree with you 100% instead of an emergency situation.
The question if we were to do this, and it's in my opinion that we need to do this in August, just for the simple fact that the schools are coming back in November, which I think would ultimately shoot us in the foot. I think that we would have no chance whatsoever to make this thing happen. With that being said, if we don't at least to start a conversation and put something on tonight, we have no shot for August.
No, I don't think that's true.
That is true. I looked it up. We have no shot unless we start initiating on a first reading something tonight.
We don't have
to begin the conversation.
We can't do a first reading because we don't have anything written up.
It's a special agenda.
It's a special.
Right.
April, May, June, July.
You have to have it in by
90 days prior to the election. So if it's like August 4th, you'd have to have it. You go backwards, July 4th, June 4th, May 4th. So you have to have it done.
So you'd have two meetings in April, and then you'd
have
to call a special meeting.
Yeah, or you'd have to call a special meeting.
That's all.
I just wanted to put that out there.
Okay. You can't do it tonight because you can't get to the agenda. Okay, thank you all.
All right, do we have 5 minutes before we go out?
Yeah, we got to get
Joseph. Yes, Mayor, it's your meeting. Or Nick, it's your meeting now.
We got to get Joseph.
Okay.
What?
5 minutes.
10 minutes.
Oh, right. 10 minutes. Woo, that's better than I got this morning.
Do I leave?
I got to get Joseph. Oh, I got to get Joseph.